At Taronga Zoo, it's a huge day. After 2 years of planning, the chimp move is about to begin. Senior vet Larry Vogelnest is taking no chances. He's in charge of a 20-strong team who will anaesthetise the chimps one by one.
We can't just take them out of their enclosure and walk them across the zoo, and there are so many reasons. I mean, they're dangerous, obviously. They would be so scared, in fact, if we even tried to, and, of course, a great risk to people. So we have to have them fully unconscious. In order to do that, we have to fire a little dart into them. So the little gun we use, it's not a particularly complicated bit of equipment. Just uses compressed CO2 to propel the dart. This is a laser sight here on the pistol, so that allows us to pretty much know where the dart's going to hit the animal, and that's an advantage as well, obviously. The other interesting thing, sometimes it works, is that the chimp will see the red dot on their skin and it distracts them momentarily, and then when you're ready, just boom.
Yeah, hi, so we're just letting you know that we're about to commence the chimp move, so all people involved are going to turn to channel 3.
Thank you.
Of course, this is an opportunity for us to give them a full check over, vaccinate them, take blood samples. There's certainly potential for things to go wrong. Probably the thing that worries us more than anything else is the chimp waking up. The chances, I think, of them actually being able to wake up so much and stay awake enough to be dangerous is extremely low. Nevertheless, to have a chimp suddenly sit up and then fall asleep again is it'd be a terrible thing. Thankfully, it hasn't happened to me, but there is potential for that.
Yeah, he's been affected by it.
There's a possibility a chimp could die. Animals can die under anaesthesia for various reasons.
Keepers believe it's now safe to enter the den. After 15 minutes, Labutu's fallen unconscious. But there's still a chance he could wake at any moment and, powered by a surge of adrenaline, become extremely dangerous.
Can I keep his head up to chimp for me and just give him a hand when Labutu gets there, just for lifting?
An adult male has 5 to 6 times the strength of a human. As a precaution against his waking, Labutu's arms and legs are manacled to the stretcher. He's also covered with a thick net for the 300-metre journey across the zoo to his new home.
The VQC van's on its way back.
So we've just got Labutu into the chimp house now. We're going to put him onto the table here, and then the first thing I'm going to do is get him stabilised on the machine. So as part of his routine health examination, we do a suite of tests, which includes getting blood, and we look at a variety of different things in the blood, and he'll also have a skin test as part of a standard screening process for TB. And we also do a thorough physical exam just to assess his general health.
So far, so good. The move's going to schedule. Back at the chimp's temporary home, Labutu's number one male ally is next to be darted.
So Chimbuka is one of the big males as well in the group. He seems to have copped a lot of flack from some of the other males, and we have been a little bit concerned about his health, actually. So all the others are going to get a thorough checkup, but we're going to actually take him to the hospital and take some x-rays and things like that, and just make sure that everything's okay.
Chimbuka's been moved now to avoid further violence amongst the group.
We wanted Chimbuka to go because we want Chimbuka and Labutu to have more time to build on their relationship, you know, basically reinforce their bond, and so, you know, sort of be prepared for the arrival of the other two males.
Although Chimbuka was relatively compliant, Larry can't be precisely sure how much anaesthetic the dart released, so Chimbuka's closely monitored on his journey to the vet hospital. While Chimbuka is being prepared to go under his general anaesthetic, at the new chimp house, Labutu's health check is going well.
Labutu looks pretty good. I'll give him an injection that's a reversal agent, and what that is going to do is to counteract the anaesthetic drug that I've given him earlier in the dart. So I would expect within the next 15 or 20 minutes that he's going to start coming around, and often they come around quite quickly.
When Labutu wakes, His grandmother will be there to reassure him through those anxious first hours.
So I'll just wait until Elle comes.
60-year-old Lulu is simply too old to be anaesthetised, so she'll be the only one put in a crate and lifted fully conscious to the new sanctuary by forklift.
So that's really cool. Lulu, now I'm going to... She's a very sweet, older lady, very pleasant and gentle most of the time, so she's our sweetheart. Good girl.
All right, she's coming out. There she
goes, sweetie. Good girl, Lulu.
Lulu's the only chimp here who was once raised as a pet. She's very comfortable with humans and needs no prompting to find her way down to the crate.
Come on, Lulu.
Lulu had an incredible life history, wild caught, hand-raised, moved around to different roadside circuses or roadside zoos, ended up in a zoo in the United States when, of course, she became unmanageable, which is pretty much the norm for chimpanzees that are hand-raised in households.
She loves it, you know? We just open the slides for her, and because she knows there's something happening and she knows that we need for her to go in the crate, she's very obliging. She knows we're going to look after her and she knows that her family will be there soon. She's not like the others. She's got varied life experience, so that comes into play here. She's not as nervous. She's happy to get in there and do what we need her to do. She's just looking for the next adventure.